dear students, welcome to Narayana Lai classes. Today I am going to explain 29th graded assignment. The topic is diversity in living organisms. Okay, so the question number 1, it asks that Pisces are exclusively dash. So the Pisces are exclusively, we know that the Pisces include fishes, so they are exclusively aquatic animals. Okay, we know that they cannot live without water for a second even, so that is why they are the organisms which are living in water always, they are termed as aquatic. So the Pisces are aquatic animals. Question number 2, that fish's skin is covered with small dash. So the answer is, the skin of the fishes are covered with scales or plates. Can be scales also, can be called as plates. So if you have ever seen the fishes closely, like if you have observed these kinds of scales present on the skin, so these are the scales which are present all over the skin of fishes. Fine. Now the question number 3, it asks that since fishes live in water, they obtain the oxygen which is dissolved in water by dash. So the answer to question number 3 is, they obtain the oxygen which is dissolved in water by gills. They have the respiratory organs of fishes are gills. How come they like this? This is the mouth of the fish, and they, from the mouth the water enters, and here the gills are present in the form of these fine lamellae called as gill slits. When the water passes through these gill slits, then the oxygen which is dissolved in the water is absorbed by the gills. So the respiratory organs of fishes are gills, by which they take in oxygen dissolved in water. Now the question number 4, it asks that their body of fish is dash, and a muscular tail present at the back helps in dash. So we know very well that the body of fishes is streamlined. So the answer to question number 4 is, fishes have streamlined body, and the muscular tail which is present help in the movement. What is the meaning of streamline? That means the body is tapering at the ends but bulging in the middle. This is the meaning of streamlined body, which actually helps the fishes to resist the water current. So both the things, the streamlined body as well as the tail which is present at the end, helps in movement. Fine. Now the question number 5, it asks that some fishes are with skeleton made exclusively of cartilage. So the answer is, shark is termed as cartilaginous fish. There are two types of fish, bony fishes and cartilaginous fishes. So shark is cartilaginous fish because the skeleton is made exclusively of cartilage. What is cartilage? It is actually a soft bone. It is present in our body also, here in the nose and the ear lobes. So these are very soft because of the presence of cartilage. So shark has cartilaginous skeleton. Now the question number 6, it asks that some fishes with skeleton made of both bone and the cartilage, as the skeleton present in our body also, it consists of the bones as well as cartilage both. So the answer to that is rohu. Okay, rohu, it is a very famous fish. So it has the skeleton which is made up of both the bones and cartilage. Fine. Now the question number 7, that all the chordates have dash dash and dash. So what all the chordates have? They have a notochord. They have a notochord and they have a dorsal nerve cord. Dorsal means present at the back. Fine. So in all the chordates, notochord and dorsal nerve cord is present at the back of the body. So these two terms are actually sometimes confusing, that what is notochord and what is nerve cord, because it seems same. So notochord belongs to the skeleton. It is a skeletal tissue, but nerve cord belongs to central nervous system. So it consists of nerves. So both are different. It belongs to the skeleton, but the nerve cord belongs to central nervous system. It consists of nervous tissue. Fine. Now the question number 8, it asks that vertebrate have a true dash and dash. So vertebrate have, question number 8, vertebrates have a true vertebral column and internal skeleton. They have a true vertebral column as well as internal skeleton. So what are the function of these things? Vertebral column, which is present at the entire back side of the vertebrate, it supports the body. It supports the body, helps the body to stand erect, this vertebral column. Internal skeleton also provides the strength, the support, as well as it provides the framework and shape to the body. So all the vertebrates have vertebral column as well as internal skeleton. Now the question number 9, electric ray, string ray and scoliodon, what they belong to, which group they belong to. So all the three, the electric ray, the string ray, scoliodon, are all fishes. So they belong to the phylum Pisces. Okay, they belong to the phylum Pisces. Pisces means all are fishes. They belong to Pisces. Now, question number 10, it asks, what are cold-blooded animals? So, the cold-blooded animals, which phylum are present in cold-blooded animals? All the reptiles, then Pisces and amphibians. All are cold-blooded animals because they cannot regulate their body temperature. Why they are cold-blooded? They cannot regulate their body temperature. So what is the meaning? The meaning is, their body temperature depends on the temperature of the surrounding. If the surrounding, the outside temperature where they are present, these cold-blooded animals, if the temperature is high, then their body temperature will become high. Or if the outside temperature is very low, then their body temperature will become low. So these cold-blooded animals cannot regulate their body temperature. And what are the phylums? Reptiles, Pisces and amphibians, they come under this. So thank you students, I hope you have understood all the answers. Thank you so very much.